Our today's session is regarding the RSC Ansible lab setup. So what is the course of your this particular RSC? That is RH-294. So this is the code, exam code of this one. So this is Ansible. So Ansible just a management and configuration tool. So by using this particular tool, we can deploy all types of work. We can perform all types of work. But before this, we should have to ready the lab for Ansible. So these are some steps that I will follow step by step. So first, I will start this from step one. So that is regarding to create a local EM repository. So I will create first EM repository. So Rahul, have you knowledge regarding this? That I have already told you in RSCSA. So how to create a EM setup? So first check we have a DVD or not in my machine. So that is recently created machine. So it's fresh machine. So this is my DVD. So first of all, you should have the DVD. So what are your requirements for this? So you should have media of your RHEL 8 or RHEL 7. It can be 8.0, 8.2, 8.1, anything. So this is our first requirements that we should have. RHEL 8 point media. So this is my DAB SR0. So first create a local EM repository. So what are the steps that I will follow? So that I perform the commands, these that I will write here. So first, create a folder mkdir/RHEL8DVD. So this is our first command. So copy this and paste here. So that command that I will follow, so I will write here. So there is no issue when you create the lab setup. So this is our first command. Then move to this particular location, RHEL DVD. So see here, there's nothing in this. So copy this whole DVD in this particular location. First, this is my first step. But because of the issue of the space, we have less space in my system. So I will not copy this one. So just I will mount this. If you want to copy this, use this particular command, cp/run. So I will use this particular command also, media root. Admin user. So this is the admin. And this we have. So just type star. Star means copy all the content that is in my DVD. So this is my DVD label, and this all the content that present will copy. In which location? /RHEL8, then -RVF. So this is the whole command. But I am not using this particular command. If you want to use this command, so you can use this. But or we can use another command also. So this can be a first step. And if you do not want to copy the whole DVD in your local machine, then you can follow this particular path also. So just I will do Control C. Use this command mount/dev/sr0. So this is my media. And I want to mount this particular media in which location? In my this location, this one. So just type here /RHEL8DVD. So this will be mounted in my system. See here. So now this particular DVD is mounted in this particular location. So this is the command. So we can use this particular also, this one. See, yes. So we can use this particular command and we can use this particular command. So my media will be mounted on this location. But when you reboot your machine, this will be unmounted. So again and again, we should follow this particular command. So no issue, it's not a big deal. So if I want to enable this in a loop, we can also enable this in a loop. It will automatically mount it. That I will show later. So these are my two commands. The first one is this, second one is this. So we can use this one also, this one also. And after them, go to this location, RHEL, so cd/etc/yum.repos.d. Do this location and create. Go to this location. So this is our next command. Go to this location and create a file. So I will not create the whole file. I have a file already that I will just copy and paste. So create a file. File name is, so just vim, in this provide a name dot, extension will be a repo. So this is vim server dot repo. So this is the location, then just enter here. Okay, not in this machine. I have this control load machine. So just shut down this machine first. I will configure this machine later, only this machine. So I have a control load, already a control load where I have configured the file. So just copy and paste. Root password. So just cat /etc/yum.repos.d. yum.repos.d. In this we have a file server.repo. Copy all the lines. So these all are the lines. So just go to the control one location, just paste here. So what is this? Is my base OS. Provide any name here. This is the base URL information file. In this we have these two slats, and this is the location of my local machine, RHEL 8 DVD, and this is the folder location where the all the packages are available. GPG check 0 enabled, yes. AppStream enabled, this one. But at this time we have no package regarding this, so I will use this later. Only these two we have in my DVD. So this is the location of my DVD. This is also location of my DVD. If I want to enable this one, so we should have this particular package. But at this time we have no package regarding this one. So just only these will work. This will work and this also work. So just save this. Then perform a command to check this is working or not. So see, yum repo list.
ब्लैक हो गई एकदम, कुछ दिख नहीं रहा।
माय स्क्रीन इज नॉट अवेलेबल फॉर यू, जस्ट ब्लैंक।
यस सर,
आई विल स्टॉप दिस फर्स्ट, स्टॉप दिस देन अगेन स्टार्ट। नाउ चेक इट्स विजिबल और नॉट।
नो सर।
नाउ चेक अगेन राहुल।
यस सर, नाउ इट इज विजिबल।
यस सर, इट्स विजिबल सर फॉर मी।
ओके ओके, नाउ सी दिस इज इनेबल। ओके, नो इशू। सो दिस इज इनेबल, दिस इज इनेबल, बट हियर सी दिस वन, बिकॉज आई एट दिस टाइम वी हैव नो पैकेज रिगार्डिंग दिस, सो वी शुड हैव दिस पर्टिकुलर पैकेज ऑन माई मशीन ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर लोकेशन, दिस वन, बट एट दिस टाइम वी हैव नो। सो फॉर दिस आई विल शो यू दिस लेटर, ओनली दिस वन, ओनली दिस दिस टू। सो वॉट आई विल डू, जस्ट क्रिएट अ फाइल, फाइल नेम इज, इट कैन बी एनीथिंग, एंड वी शुड हैव दिस ऑल द कंटेंट। सो आई विल कॉपी दिस होल थिंग, दिस वन, जस्ट सी, दिस इज द कंसेप्ट। सो जस्ट क्रिएट अ फाइल, द नेम ऑफ द फाइल बाई यूजिंग द विम कमांड। सो यूज योर विम, जस्ट गिव एनी नेम, बेस URL information, stream information. I will show this later because at this time in my machine, in this particular location, there is no Ansible packages. Or in your DBD, Ansible package is not available. So you should have to download this from the Red Hat site. After the downloading, this package will be enabled. So I will show this later. Only these two things that you should have to know. Then use this particular command, this one, to check your yum is working or not. See, enabled, enabled. So just copy this particular command, just paste here. After then, install a package to check the package being to install or not. So just yum install any package, check this telnet package for the installation, just for demonstration. So now I am able to install the packages. It means in my yum repository is working properly in my control node machine. So now, so this is your first step. In this step, what we should have to do on your control node machine, control node and manage host also, but I will perform this particular task on manage host later. At this time, only this particular machine. So I have completed this particular task on this machine, only just control node machine. So what is your second step? My second step is that, so first provide the machine name, it means machine name, or we can say that it's your computer name, computer name. So we can communicate by using the name, or we can say that this is your host name. So provide the host name on your machine. So this is our second step, and also provide the IP address. So this is the first step, host name, this one, and IP address also. So IP and host name, these two things will be required, and provide this entry, name and IP entry, in your this one. So this is your name and this is the IP, this is the name, this is the IP, in a host file. So that is to be required. So first provide the machine name. So at this time, my machine name is localhost. So what is the command, Rahul, to change the host name? So tell me the command. What is the command to change your host name? Have you remembered or not? No, it's not a SU. I want to change my post name. It means I want to change this particular name. So what is the command to change this name? I want to provide a name that is control node. And this is my domain name. So I want to provide the FQDN to this machine. So what is the command? So it's a host name CTL. So it's a host name CTL command to provide the host name. Set host name. This is the command. And I want to provide, it's a control node. Node, N-O-D, control node dot lab dot example example.com. You can provide anything. This is my domain name, lab.example.com. You can provide just only example.com, lab.example, and any other name. So this is my name. So just copy this one and paste here. So this is the command. Now, just type here bash to check your name is changed or not. So now see, this name will be changed. So just type. So your name will be changed. Now, what is the next thing? This is your third step. So provide, give this entry, name and IP entry in which particular file, etc host file. So I can communicate by using the name. So what is the next step? I want to communicate by using this particular name, but at this time I am not able to communicate because in my system, name service is not working. So for the name service, we can use host file and we can use DNS. DNS, domain name system. But at this time, we have no DNS in my system. So I will use for local management this particular host file for the name resolution. So I want to perform this name resolution. In my machine. So we should have to provide this entry in my host file. So just vim/etc/hosts and copy this one, just paste here. Okay, this is the command of this one. So this, see. So this is the information that we should have to provide. So just delete this whole one that is not required for this. So go to this location, just press I. What IP that you want to provide? Just give IP. I want to provide this IP on my control board machine that at this time, I'm not providing this, but I will provide this. So just give the IP and control node dot lab dot example dot com and give the host name information. CONTROL control node. This one. If you want to provide any other alias, you can also provide this one. So just copy this one and paste here. And I will create another machine also. That is a 100 machine. I will provide the IP for. I will create another machine also. So this is my manage host. Managed host one. So I will change this one also. 1 and change here managed host 1 and just change here also. Okay, this is 2, not a 1. It's a 2 machine. And the IP address of this one is 200. So I will create, at this time we have only just one machine. These machine I will create later, but I can provide this entry before creation also. So just I have provided this entry for the name resolution, so we can communicate this particular name in my machine. So I want to communicate this one, but at this time we have no machine, 200, 100, only this machine. So I will create this machine. This is my manage host 1 machine, and I will create a 1 machine also for my lab setup. So this has been completed. So just copy this one, this entry. So just copy this and just paste here. This one. So this step has been completed. Yes, if we want, suppose, see here, ping control node. So control control node. So at this time the network is unreachable because we have not, I'm not providing the IP also in this machine. See here, there's no IP. So at this time there's no communication, but I will provide the just entry first. If I have the IP address regarding this, then we are able to communicate this machine by using the name also and by using the IP also. But at this time we have no IP in my machine. So first we should have provided this entry. So provide the IP address in your machine. So see this one. First give computer name and provide the IP address. So this step I have missed. So first you should have to provide the IP address, then you should give this entry. So I have missed this step. So this is my give IP address on which machine? Control node and manage host also. Host machine, machines, because I will create 2 manage host machines. So these steps I have missed. So I will use this also. So what is the command to give the IP address? So at this time we have no IP. See, no IP address at this time. So what is the command, Rahul? Which command I will use? So give me the command in chat box. If you have remembered, give me the command. Jitu and Rahul, both of you. So give me the command. What is the command that I will use to provide the IP address? So paste this in a chat box, then I will check your command is right or not. So Gitu, have you remembered or not? Okay, no issue. So that is NMCLI connection modify. So it's not a full command. I want full command, not NMCLI connection modify This is my connection name, IP version 4 dot addresses, provide IP 10.10/24, IP version 4 method. So this is your first question of RACSA exam. So first you should have to provide the manual IP address and connection auto connect. Yes. So this is our first command and NMCLI connection up. This is my connection name. So I have completed this step. So just copy and paste here. Now I will check what is my IP address. So just type here grep inet. Now check. This is my IP address. So I am able to communicate by this particular name. So see, I am able to communicate with name or not. So just type this particular name, then I am able to communicate. See this one. Now we are able to communicate with name. So this name will be converted. So this is my IP address. This is my name. This is my IP. So this is the concept regarding the name resolution. So at this time in my machine, name resolution is working because I have provided this particular entry in my cat/etc host file. Which particular file? This particular file. So my resolution, name resolution will work. So at this time only we have one machine. These machine that I will later. So these entry for the later demonstration. So this is proof. So this is the concept. So my name resolution is working in my machine. So this has been completed. This also has been completed. And what is the next step? So just create a user by any name. So just use this one. First, I will own my, so I will power up this machine. So just on my manage host machine. So these three steps I will perform in this machine first, then I will use that particular later. So this is my control load machine. In this, we have completed three steps. And in manage host, I will also complete three steps. Then I will use this particular fourth step in both machine. So login, just provide password. Preferences, color, black on white. So what is the first step for this one? So again, move to first step. See, so create a local YAML repository. Suppose if I want to install the Red Hat package on this particular machine, any package like HTTP, Telnet, then what I will do first? So first we should have to create the local YAML repository. So what are the steps? So these are the steps that I follow. Just copy and paste here. So this will be created. Just use this one. So you should follow these steps. How you will create your lab setup? I will provide these all commands. Then you should just copy and paste in your machine also. So this first step has been completed. Now we want to create. So go to this particular location, just copy, paste, just only just copy and paste. See here, at this time we have no machine. So go to this location, just paste, then. So only use these two. that is not needed in your control load machine. So there is no need to install Ansible package on your control load machine. So just provide these two entries only. Just save this. So your task will be easy. Just copy, and paste. Same steps you will follow. Then use this particular command. Just copy and paste also here. See, you are able to work. And these are two repositories that is to be enabled in your machine. If you want to install any package, like Telnet, the same package. Now you are able to install this particular package in manage host machine also. Next, what is? Then give this particular command to change your host name also. So use this one. So just cd, just paste here, but I want to provide change my name. So that is managed host one. So this is my managed host machine. So just provide managed host one. Now, just use bash to change your shell session. Now check, you have two sessions. This is my first session, this is my second session. So this is my second bash session. Then I can recognize this name is work on my machine. But if I want to work, I want to check the connectivity with name. But see here, there's no name resolution service that is recognized on your machine. So we should have to provide the entry in host file also. Suppose we want to communicate to control node machine by using the name. See here, I am not able to perform the name resolution functionality, because for the name resolution, we should have the entry in etc host file, or we can use other service also. We can use DNS also. So see, this is my first command. So just give IP also first, this one. So provide the IP, not this one. So just copy this whole command. Just copy this one, paste here. So just change the IP. So just change here 100 only. This whole thing will be same. Only the IP will be changed. Connection up. So which connection? This one. So at this time, this is the IP of this machine. See, the IP will be changed. So I have completed this step also. Then check the next one. See, so this is the IP. So just grab here INET. So this is my 100 IP. Now we want to check the connectivity again. No, at this time we have the IP also, but the my name resolution service will not work in my machine. I can communicate by using the IP only, just, but not by using the name. But I want the communication by using the IP. So see here, there is a connectivity, but I can communicate by using the IP only, not by using the name. So for this, we should have to provide the entry in etc host file. So just go to this particular location, this machine. Hosts. Just copy whole thing, this one from this machine, just copy this one and paste here, vim/etc/hosts. just I and just paste here. So this service will work. See again by using name. And my own machine also, this is my own machine. I can communicate by my own machine also by using the name. So at this time, I am able to communicate by using name and IP also. So this all has been completed. This also has been completed. This also has been completed. So these three steps will be complete in my managed host machine also. So if we have this type of documentation, so you will take just only 10 to 20 minutes to complete the lab setup. So this is very helpful for you. Then what is the next step that I should follow and I will follow? So go to the control load machine again. So this is my control load machine. So here we should have to create user, provide any name. Username is DevOps and give the password and enable SSH, enable key based authentication. It means key pair authentication, key pair. You can say that. Or we can say that passwordless authentication. Passwordless, not a password based. We want to communicate by using the SSH functionality, SSHD. So first create a user. After then, this is your second step. So this is my first step. This is my second step. So these two steps, so you should follow these. So just create a user. The username is, it can be anything. So just provide DevOps. DevOps. Provide the password. Password also. Then just give name. Retype. So these two steps will be complete. So what is the first step? So this is my first step. Create a user. So just copy this one. So this is the first step. And what is the second step? So this is your second step. So these two steps has been completed. So just create a user and create this user in this machine also. So see, so user add again, DevOps, same name. Provide password any password here that you want to assign. So create and give password on control load machine and managed host machine. So the two steps that you should follow in your this machine also and this machine also. So you should have to create a user. So this has been completed and check you are able to perform the name resolution or not. So see, just do SSH. SU hyphen DevOps SSH DevOps at the rate which machine? Manage host machine. Manage host one. This machine. So just first check the fingerprint, match the fingerprint, yes. Then provide the password that you have assigned. So I'm able to SSH this machine, but I want the SSH by using key pair. So just create a key pair. It means private key or public key. So you should have to use RSA authentication. It means private or public key. Private and public key. So these two pairs you should have to create. So first, what I will do, just log into this machine. At this time, ssh-keygen, this one. So this is the command. Just copy this. So use this on which machine? Control node also. And manage host machine also. This machine. Then just keygen, generate SSH key, just enter and again enter, again enter. So this all steps has been completed. So see this one, I will copy this whole thing for your better understanding. So what I will do, just this, just enter, then just enter again, then this has been created. So public key has been created in this location, and this is my private key. So this is my private key and this is my public key, this one. So these two key has been created on this particular location. So at this time, we have this particular public key for this particular control node machine. So this is my public key. So we should have to send this particular public key on manage host. So we can communicate by using this particular RSA authentication. This one. So now, what is the next command? Next command is that ssh-copyid. Send this on this particular user that available on managed host one, this machine. So see, go to the location of this one, su-devops, check this, ls-la. At this time, there is no SSH folder available in this machine. So in this SSH folder will create, and authorized key will automatically paste here. So I will show this. At this time, there is no. Now use this command. So copy this one. Just enter, provide the password. Then we are able to send this particular key. So copy this whole thing again. See. This step has been completed. Now, what is the next step? Go to this location, then check again. Then see, this folder has been created. .sss, and here, check this one. This is the key, that authorized key. So you can check this one. If you want to check this, so you can check this. See, this is your key. So this key has been sent on this machine. So see, I will show this here. This RSA key for which machine? This machine. So this machine have at this time this key. So now check again. I'm able to take the SSH without the password. So do this step again, this step. See, I am able to do SSH without the password. See, so this whole, so I am not providing any password. See here, no password information here. So this has been completed. So this step has been completed. But if I want to perform any command here, see here, user add, user one, I want to command, perform this command. But see, at this time, this user have no privilege. So now, what is the next step? So provide the privilege for this user. So what is the next step? In this step, it's 4.1, 4.2. So what is the next step? This is my next step. So we should have to provide. So see, I am not able to do any types of work. See, so for this condition, we should have to provide the privilege. So just provide the privilege. So right here, provide the privilege. Now, see this. I want to at this time on this machine, just log out. So I want to provide the privilege. So go to this machine to provide the privilege. Just user add here, hyphen M, no, hyphen capital G. It's a user mode. So we use this particular command. Use this user in wheel group. This is my wheel group. And which user? The user is DevOps. DevOps. So this user cannot add this particular user, its own user, in this machine. So what I will do? So just log out from this machine. So root can provide, root can add this particular user in this particular group. So this is an administrative group. So this user can obtain the permission, it means to perform the sudo command. Privilege by using the which method? So I want to provide the sudo privilege. Sudo privilege. So I want to provide this type of privilege. So this user can perform any command by using the sudo. So in sudoers file, we should have to provide this one. So that's etc. In this, we have a file, sudo, this file. See, this entry has been done. Now check again. So this one, so I'm not perform, not able. So in this machine, use this particular command. Then check again to create a user. So use user add command again. No, first su again, hyphen DevOps, then check again user add user one. At this time, I'm not performing this. So just type sudo here. Now provide the password, but it required a sudo password, but I do not want the sudo password. Then we should have to change one more setting also. So at this time, log into this machine, create user. So without sudo, you cannot perform this particular command. By using sudo, you can perform this command. Now, just check this user is created or not. Etc, passwd, just grep here, grep, and user one. Now, so just copy this whole thing. spaced here. Now, so I want to remove this one. I do not want the sudo password again and again. So what I will do, go to this location, vim/etc, sudoers, this particular file, this file, but not by using this user. So vim/etc sudoers. So just copy this and go to this location. So just paste, and this step is sudo user add user one. First step here. This is the step that you should follow. So these all steps will be completed. And what is the last one? In this file, go to down, go to line 100 and down again. See, enable this particular, this one. This is wheel. I am a member of wheel group. All, it's right. All again, it's right. So provide this entry before all. So this entry in front of all. So sudo password will not required. You can paste this particular entry on this one. So I want to perform any command without a password. So just do nothing. Enable this one only. Just enable this one. Then we are able to do this. So just uncomment this line. This whole line. Uncomment this whole line. Just this particular line. It means uncomment this line and save this. Save this file. Then just save this, write in quit. Now perform this command again. See, su and create user 2. Now there is no need to provide the sudo password again and again. So this is, these are the steps that we should follow. See, at this time there is no need to provide the password. So this is the step. Now just log out here. So see again here on this machine. Now I am able to access this machine. Now perform this command on this machine. So see, this machine, this is my control load machine. From this, I can access this particular machine without a password, and we can also, no need to provide the password, sudo password again and again. So these are the steps. So just copy this one also. I will manage this whole thing, then I will send you this whole data documentation. So now I have completed these four steps. Then what is the next step? So this is my last step. So first you should have to need to download this one from your internet, this RPM package. Then you are able to perform the Ansible command. Suppose if I am using here, because Ansible is not present in my machine. See this one. No Ansible in this particular location. So we should have to install this particular package. So this is our last step for this one. But I will follow one more step. It's sudoers file. We should also provide this entry in sudoers file also. So just vim/etc. So just provide the password user mode. No. vim/etc sudoers, go to this location and give a entry also here. Just type yy and p. Just give the name of the user in control node machine also. So that is DevOps user. And all also here, and provide one more entry here. So that is regarding this one, this particular. So just paste this one. So DevOps user from any location perform this particular command. So in this machine also, you should have to provide this entry. So just do this in control node machine also. So this is control node, and what is the entry that we have provided for this? So that is regarding this one. So that is this entry. So just type here this entry also, then save this one, then save this file also. This, so you should have to save this particular file. And now just type su-devops. We are able to run sudo command or not? Sudo user add, this user add command. Okay, caps lock is on. User add user 11. See, I am able to perform this particular command. cat/etc pass wd grep u11. See, so this whole thing will be complete in control node machine also. So these are the last step for control node also. And this is the last step 5. So at this time, we have no package on this machine. So we should have to copy this one on this machine. Then we are able to communicate. Then we are able to perform this particular command. So the command is Ansible. Which Ansible? At this time, we have no Ansible package. So first install the package. So I will check I have Ansible package or not. So just give me 1 minute. Then I will perform this. So this is net1 tcp 10.88. okay, good. Open winscp. Just start, provide the password, save, just login, update. So root. So I want to copy the package. The package is that is available on my data. So what is where is the package? ISO, this is the package. So just copy this one. Just copy this package, not the whole package. This is not, yes, this is the package. So just copy this one and paste here in slash location. So just paste this. Now, this has been copied. So see, in this machine, go to this location, slash, see. I have this package, so we should have to copy this in which location? Slash. So I will create another one folder, mkdir slash rhl8 underscore ansible, this one, ansible hyphen 2.8, this one. So I will create a folder first, then move this one. So copy this whole in which location? In this location. Then hyphen rvf. So this package has been completed. So ls slash. So this one. So we should have to provide the location for this one in this. So just copy this location. Here package is available. This one. Vim slash etc yum dot repos dot d. No, not this. One in this we have a file that is server.repo. So go down. So at this time my location is not this, my location is this one. So just remove this whole thing. So my location is this. So at this time this package is available in this particular RHL 8 DBD underscore Ansible, this particular folder. So this is my location at this time. So just write and quit and yum repo list all, check. So now see here, this will be complete. This also available at this time. We have the Ansible package on this particular location. So this is enabled. Last time that is disabled. So see, install. So use here yum install Ansible. Just star here. Check. So we have how many packages? This particular Ansible packages is available in my machine. This is Python 3. Jinja template, mark safe, SSS, this one. So this, all the steps that will require 101 MB of size. So this will be installed in my machine. Just type Y here. So this is the last step that we should follow. So now run that particular command again. This particular command, which command? Then this particular Ansible command is available in this particular location. Then you are able to perform this command hyphen hyphen version. So this is the last step. So what is the steps that I have completed? So this is the step. So this one, just copy this. So you can change the this path also if that you want to define. Then this particular, then see, so just take cat here. In this we have server.repo, just this location. So this is the last step that we have to follow. So this has been completed. Then em repo list all. So this is the last one. Some steps. See, now install this particular package. So when we install this particular package, what is our requirements? So these whole our requirements. So just copy whole packages. These all the packages. These all six packages. The size of this one is that. Just follow this one. So I will copy this whole thing for the better understanding. And this whole thing that I will copy. This one. So these all that I will copy also. So these are the steps. Suppose if I want to create a user in my machine by using Ansible in my local host machine, I want to perform a task, and by using any module -m module that is user module -argument, and I want to create a user. Name of the user is, so that is Ansible user one, and state, so that is state, define the state that is present. Then I'm able to perform this command or not? See here, I'm able to perform this particular command. So this is our last. I am able to communicate by using the Ansible command. So this whole thing will be complete. So these are all the steps that we should need to create the lab setup, whole lab setup. So Rahul and Geetu, any doubt regarding any step? I have mentioned all the steps one by one that I will perform in these two machines. Then these two machines has been ready. So any doubt regarding this one? So you can ask any question. Rahul, any question regarding this? Hello? At this time, we have two machines. One is control load machine, second is manage host machine. That is only one. But later I will create one more machine. So that is, we have required two, minimum one manage host machine, and we can add more than one. So I will add one more machine for other demonstration, some more practical that will require three machines. So I have completed all the steps in a one command, one method. So if we have only two machines, so you should have to add only two IP. If you have three machines, four machines, and other machines, so you should have to provide the entry of that particular machine also. But at this time, we have only two machines. So these two, at this time, we have two machines. That is not needed. When we create this machine, then there is no So you should not provide this entry again, because you have already provided this entry. So just create that machine on for the managed host, then we are able to communicate by using the name, if we have machine. If we don't have, so we don't need to provide this entry. Only just these two entry at this time, that it will be required. Okay. And Gitu, any other doubt?
No, sir.
So this is the whole. Then see, this day one completed, and what is day two? Where is day one? There's no what are the steps in day two? These all steps that I will complete in next class, not today class. So these are the steps that will that I can follow on this lab. Just give me was just 5 minutes, then I will start this chapter. Okay. Today I will start this chapter. Just give me was 2 and 3 minutes. Then I will start these steps of chapter this. So just so our lab has been completed, it's ready for control node machine. Then I will start your second chapter, that is regarding deploying Ansible. So this is the step. This is your first lab, that is regarding the installation. Installation of Ansible. So for installing the Ansible package, you should follow these all steps regarding the lab setup. Lab setup. So this completed, then I will follow the next step. So that is my chapter 2, how to deploy Ansible. It means for the deployment of Ansible, we should need some other steps. So in this, we will discuss how to build, how to create inventory file. So what is inventory file? Rahul, any knowledge regarding inventory file? Any knowledge? Okay. See, so what is inventory? Inventory is just a file. It's a collection of host. Host means managed host. At this time, we have only one managed host. In my machine, we have only just one managed host. So it's a collection of. How Ansible can recognize how to perform that particular work, any work on which particular machine? So by using the inventory file, my Ansible, my control node machine can recognize in which particular machine you should have to follow that particular work. So inventory define the control host. So all the control host machine entry will be provided in this particular inventory file, so that Ansible can understand, Ansible can manage those machines. So those machines that are known as managed host machine. So Ansible can manage these machines. These hosts can also be assigned in a group also, and these can also be assigned in an individual. So the entry can be provided in a group also. The entry can be provided in an individual also. Groups can contain a child group. It means we want to perform a task on a multiple groups, then we can create group under the group. So that is, I will create. It means member of multiple groups. One group, we can contain more than one group. So these groups, that is a part of that master group. So that is called child group. So the inventory file can also set the variable. It means if you want to provide the variable entry, So you can also provide the variable entry in inventory file also. So inventory file also used to provide the entry for the variables also. So host inventory can be defined two ways. If I want to provide, if I want to create the inventory file, so these have two methods. The first one is a static inventory file. The second one is dynamic host inventory file. All the hosts contain the entry in inventory file. So that is using, by using the any script file, just like Python and any other scripts, we can use this. So that is called dynamic host inventory. So in this, scripts will require and can all other part, other program also, it can be by using the external source, any provider, other provider also. So in this first, we will discuss how to create the static inventory file. We have by default create an inventory file that is called your default. So that is, so what is the your default inventory file? So that is, what is the location? This one. This is your default inventory file. This one that is contained in etc. In this etc, we have Ansible, Ansible, we have hosts. So first I will create our manual. So how to create the manual entry, how to provide the manual entry for the inventory file. So you should have to create just one file for in static inventory, just create a text file that specify the manage host that Ansible target. So can write this particular file using number of different formats. So we can use INA formats also, and we can also use YAML format also. So in this, we use this particular format that is commonly used. So suppose if we have two machine, three machine, four machines, so how Ansible can recognize? So you should have provide this entry. Suppose if I want to perform a task on this machine, this particular machine, I want to create a user on this machine, how my system can recognize? So we should have to provide this entry. See, so we have one command that is Ansible hyphen hyphen list hyphen hosts. So I want to check my own machine entry, that is local host. There is any entry, so that is by default added. So there is no need to add your own machine entry. So that is added by using the local host. Suppose if you want to check this machine is added any, so I want to add my managed host machine. So check this one, manage host one. So the machine name is manage host one. So see here, provides host list of empty. At this time, we have no entry of this particular machine in my inventory file. So see, at this time, we are through root user. See this one. And I want to create a file, any file. So give this name, any name, and provide the entry. Just type I here, managed host one. I have provided this entry like this way. We can also use full name, and we can also provide the short name. So I will provide the name in a short manner. Then check this again. See, again the same error. So you should have to provide the path hyphen I, it means for your inventory file path also. So this is my inventory. See, so now we have this particular machine entry in my this inventory file. So hyphen hyphen list host, it's a command. I want to check this machine is available on this particular inventory file or not. So if I have provided an entry in any inventory file and I want to check the entry this machine contain in this particular inventory file or not. So you can provide this entry. Suppose if I want to provide this entry just like this way, lab.mplexample.com in a full way, full method. So see here, no host match. So go to this location, just change the name. .lab.example.com. Just see, check again now. So this is my entry. If you do not want to give whole name, just you can provide star here, only just star. If I write here just like this way, then this will not match. Provide the name that you have provided in this particular inventory file. So this is my name, and just type star here. So this will be, suppose if you just copy this whole, if you want to check, I want to provide this entry in this particular file also. So at this time for the demonstration, there is no need to on this particular machine. It means at this time the need this. We have web1.example.com, we have another machine, web2.example.com, db1.example.com, db2.example.com. This is my IP. We can also provide the IP entry and we can also provide the name entry on this. So see, so just type and save this particular file. And we want to check the name. The name is which one? web1.example.com. This entry is contained in my machine, yes. And if I want to check web2 also, just give star here. So we have both machine entry in this particular file. This is my inventory file. We have entry. Suppose we want to check the whole entry that is related to, just give star here, just dot. See, we have manage host 1.lab.example.com, we have 2 web1.example.com, web2 db1, all just provide the domain name and just star here. So it will recognize all the entries contained in this particular inventory file. If I want to perform a task on this whole machine, so this inventory file path will be required. So Ansible can understand in which machine we should do SSH, and after doing the SSH, what task I want to perform. So using this particular inventory file, Ansible can perform the work. So see here, this is my IN style in a single line format. Suppose organize manage host into host group. If I want to provide this entry in a group also, then how I will provide? Host group allow you to more effectively Ansible against a collection of systems. I want to perform a task in this whole machine, whole systems. So we can provide the group name, then give only just group name here. Then task will be performed on that particular machine. So we should have to provide the section in a square bracket. So give name of that particular group in a square bracket. So bracket will be required to provide the host group name, followed by your host name and followed by your IP address also. So you can use IP also, you can use host name also of your machine. in a single line format. How? See this one. So see, go to the location again, just provide one entry. Suppose these are my web servers. These two web servers, we have two machines that is related to the database server, this one, and this is my other machine. So that is related to like Windows. These are my Windows machine. So you can provide any name. This my, so we have two groups. The first one regarding to web servers. So this is my web servers. These are my database servers and Windows. So see, so if you want to check here, just if you have type here Windows, see only one machine in this particular group, we have only one machine, and other how many machines, that is web servers. In this we have two machines. If I will perform this task on this particular group, this task will be performed on these two machines and database servers. So just type here database servers. See, database, we have type a wrong spelling, database. So we have two machine in this. So see here. So this is the steps that we should follow. Suppose host can be multiple groups. Suppose if one host, it can be a part of multiple groups. So we can provide a host entry in a multiple group also. So that is called like this. That is called nested group. Suppose, see here, I will create another group. The group name is, it can be anything. So we have type servers. In this, just provide the name of that particular. Just web servers. So this is my group name. That is called child group. But for this, we should have required this particular children prefix. So for this, this children suffix will require, not prefix, suffix. Suffix that is added in later. Prefix that is added in before. So that will be added. So C-H-I-L-D-R-E-N. Children suffix will require. Web server. The next one is Windows. So I will provide these two groups. So these groups called child group. If I just type here servers only, so these three machines, so these, this particular task will be performed on web server also and Windows machine also. So this is regarding, this is my USA, this is my Canada. So we have a group name. The group name is North America. So we have two children, Canada, USA. So this task will be performed on this machine also, these two machine also, and USA, it means these two machine also. This task will perform on fourth machine. So we can use this type of nested group. So that is called nested group, group under the group. If I want to provide the entry in a this method, so today I will complete this one. So in the next session, I will start from this range. So I will start here. So in the next session, I will start this. See.